Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First of all, let us give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving grace so that we are still given help. Introducing us from group H. As for the members of the group of three people, including myself, my name is Musfira. I will serve as moderator as well as the first presenter in this presentation on analytical exposition text material. My group members are Nurul Qalbi and Aulia Sri Wardani. Furthermore, the delivery of material and analytical exposition material, there are five important topic points starting from the definition, purpose, structure, linguistic feature, and finally example of analytical exposition text. The first is the definition of analytical exposition. The definition of analytical exposition is a type of exposition text in English that has certain rules. This text contains an opinion or argument about something logically and presents a certain point of view and issue. Analytical exposition is usually found in scientific articles, journals, magazines, and in the editorial section of newspapers or mass media. The second is the purpose of an analytical exposition text. The purpose of an analytical exposition text is to explain an opinion or argument about something in a logically way. This text aims to convey the author's view or opinion about an issue, such as object, place, or event. The main purpose of analytical exposition text is to inform or convince the reader about an issue, and the writer wants the reader to understand and agree with his or her opinion. The next will then on point 3 and 4 will be brought by my friends Aulia Sri Wardani. Aulia Sri Wardani, the floor is yours.
Okay, thank you for the time you have given. Here I will explain the structure part. The general structure of analytical exposition text includes the gist, argument, and redirection. The first part is there. The first part of an analytical exposition text, which identifies the topic to be discussed and provides the author's opinion about the topic. The second part is their argument. This section presents several reasons or arguments that support the author's opinion. And the last one is their redirection. The final part of an analytical exposition text that restates the author's opinion and states the conclusion. Okay, here I will also explain some language features in analytical exposition text include 1. Using models. 2. Using action verbs. 3. Using thinking verbs. 4. Using adverbs. 5. Using adjective. 6. Using technical terms. 7. Using general and abstract noun. And the last, using connectives or transition. Okay, thank you. Maybe that's enough explanation from me. I'll return into the moderator.
Okay, thank you Aulia Sri Wardani for your explanation about generic structure and language feature analytical exposition text. The next and the last topic about example of analytical exposition text will be presented by Nurul Qalbi. Nurul Qalbi, the floor is yours.
Well, thank you moderator. Here I will present one example of an analytical exposition text entitled Critical Study of the Issue of Global Climate Change. climate change represents a significant contemporary issue that requires urgent attention and action. The discourse surrounding climate change is complex, involving a multitude of concepts and notions that are deeply embedded in social relations and power dynamics. The lexicon of climate change, as analyzed by Dominguez, encompasses a range of terms such as hazard, risk, threat, vulnerability, resilience, adaptation, mitigation, precaution, anthropocene, and capitulation. These terms are not only scientific but also carry significant political and social implications. The discourse on climate change is not just about the physical change in the environment, but also about power relations, interests, and the way in which these concepts are used to frame the issue. The role of international organizations, particularly the United Nations and its Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, is crucial in shaping the discourse and policy response to climate change. However, the power dynamics within these organizations and the influence of capitalist corporations and nation states on their agendas have been criticized. The IPCC, for instance, has faced criticism for its reliance on conservative neoclassical economics and its limited recognition of political issues. The impacts of climate change are far-reaching, affecting not only the environment but also social, economic, and political aspects of life. The evidence of human activities contributing to global warming, including deforestation and the release of greenhouse gases, is undeniable. These activities have led to failed crops, economic slowdowns, and significant change in weather pattern, affecting economies and livelihoods worldwide. In conclusion, the issue of global climate change is multifaceted, involving not only environmental concern but also political, social, and economic dimensions. The lexicon of climate change, as analyzed, reveals the complex interplay of concepts, power relations, and interest in addressing this global challenge. While international organizations play a crucial role in framing the discourse in policy response, there is a need for a more critical engagement with the political and economic underpinning of the effort. Addressing climate change requires a comprehensive approach that goes beyond mitigation and adaptation strategies to encompass deeper social and political transformations. Okay, that's my explanation. I'll turn it back to the moderator.
Thank you, Nurul Qalbi, for reading the example of analytical exposition text. And that's the result of our presentation group. I think that's enough. We apologize if something went wrong during our presentation. Thank you, and wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.